Hi guys, in this aviation video I am going to discuss about ramjet engine. At the end of this video session you will have the idea of ramjet engine. The objective of this video presentation will be provide you the introduction of ramjet, that is what is ramjet, then its main component and its principle and working, advantages and disadvantages of ramjet and its application, and additionally how it is different from buzzjet engine, that also I will let you know. So introduction to ramjet. Ramjet engine is mechanically a simplest air breathing jet engine, produces thrust for flying vehicle. So we can say ramjet is a simple mechanical devices which do not have any rotating component like compressor and turbine. Also, so there is one question that how ramjet is producing thrust. So in ramjet engine, necessary pressure rise takes place due to design of supersonic air intake and shock wave. So here is the answer, that intake portion of ramjet engine will play a very important role in order to produce thrust. See, the key question of this slide will be, what is shock wave? Shock wave is nothing but a pressure wave, or we can say a high pressure wave, across which abrupt changes in flow properties take place. So across the shock wave, we can say pressure temperature density varies rapidly, means pressure will high and velocity will be low. So and shock wave can be of normal or oblique. Oblique means it will have acute angle, and normal means it will be perpendicular to the flow direction. Now the main component involved in ramjet engine will be supersonic diffuser, subsonic diffuser with oblique shock inlet. This is oblique shock inlet, and this portion is known as diffuser. There will be a subsonic diffuser and subsonic diffuser. Front portion will be subsonic and supersonic diffuser. Then combustion chamber section along with igniter, fuel injector and a flame holder. And last one is converging diverging nozzle. You can see this is the nozzle portion, CD nozzle you can see over here. This is the combustion chamber section, and these are the flame holders which stabilize the flame, and this is the fuel injection, or we can say fuel injector. Now the key question arises over here, why we are using oblique shock inlet? Come back to this slide. Oblique shock inlet, why we are using this pointed nose cone? See, to produce oblique shock wave with normal shock, means what we want actually. The purpose of supersonic diffuser and subsonic diffuser is very clear, that to reduce the velocity of the air coming inside the engine and to increase the pressure. So for that intention, what we are doing, we are placing a pointed nose inlet which will deviate the flow and produces 2 or 3 oblique shock at the inlet and with one normal shock wave. So what will happen, because of that 2 or 3 oblique shock and normal shock, the Mach number, which is very high at the outside of engine, will be very low at the entry of CC, means combustion chamber. For that intention we are using oblique shock inlet. So we can say in short, oblique shock inlet is used to produce 2 or 3 oblique shock together with one normal shock, so that the Mach number of air entering inside the combustion chamber will be subsonic. So at last we can say oblique shock inlet will terminate the supersonic condition of airflow at the entry of combustion chamber, and it will make the flow condition subsonic inside the combustion chamber. That's why we are preferring oblique shock inlet in case of ramjet engine. Now why do we need flame holder in combustion chamber? The reason for using flame holder in combustion chamber is just to stabilize the flame and to for the continuous combustion, so that it can be achieved easily. As I am telling that oblique shock inlet is used to make the flow subsonic. If in any case the flow condition, or we can say flow velocity, if very very high in CC, that is combustion chamber, then there may be a chances of flame to get blow off. So in order to prevent that, we are using flame holder so that it can stabilize the flame and we can achieve continuous combustion. This is the reason why we are using flame holder in ramjet engine. Now principle and working. You can see in this engine, this is oblique shock inlet and you are seeing diffuser. Supersonic diffuser will be front, then second component will be subsonic diffuser, then there will be a combustion chamber section and at last nozzle, that is CD nozzle. So what will happen in this case? First, what is the principle of ramjet engine? Ramjet engine works on the principle of ram compression. Now the question arises, what is ram compression? So ram compression, if the moving air is gradually brought to halt, halt means stop. If the moving air is brought to halt, then the pressure of the air will increase at the cost of its kinetic energy, means the pressure will be very high as compared to the velocity. Why it is happening? Ram air is what? Ram air means ramming. Ramming means something is moving very fast and in some steady flow. Means if air is stationary, then object is moving. If object is stationary, then air flow is moving very fastly. Then only ram effect comes into picture. In ramjet case, since there is no compressor and turbine, there is no rotating component, then for getting initial thrust, we are using ram effect over here. So ramjet works on the principle of ram compression, and ram compression is nothing but if the moving air is brought to halt or stop so that the pressure energy is converting into this kinetic energy is converted into pressure energy, means pressure is rising at the cost of its kinetic energy. That is known as ram effect. So ramjet engine works on the principle of ram effect. Now air will enter at very high velocity in supersonic diffuser, where velocity of the air will get reduced and pressure will very high. After that, that compressed air will enter into the subsonic diffuser, where it will get further compressed. After that, pressure will be very high. That high pressure air will enter into the combustion chamber section. Now one more thing I want to add, when initially air will enter, the Mach number will be greater than 1, because ramjet engine operates on Mach number 2 to 5 range. So when air will enter, there will be oblique shock, 2 or 3 oblique shock with 1 normal shock. Because of this oblique shock inlet, what will happen? The Mach number at one point, it will be 2, then it will reduce to 0.7, and then at the end, at the entry of combustion chamber section, it will be approximately 0.2. So this is the case when ramjet is operating at Mach number 3, means greater than 1 only. So at supersonic flow condition only, we are using ramjet engine. So now after that supersonic diffuser, the air will enter into subsonic diffuser, then after that the compressed air will enter into the combustion chamber section. In combustion chamber section, fuel is mixed with the help of fuel injector, and then it is burned with the help of igniter, and then combustion take place at the temperature of 3000 Kelvin approximately. In ramjet engine, the temperature of operating in combustion chamber will be very high. So after that, the combustion gases will be expanded into the nozzle at very high velocity, so that they leave the engine with very very high velocity. After expansion, the gases leave the engine with very high velocity compared to the air entering into the engine. So you can see outlet Mach number will be very high compared to the Mach number at inlet. So I can say the velocity of exit will be very high compared to the velocity of entering air. See, I have covered all these points. This compressed air now enter into the combustion chamber, where fuel is injected through fuel nozzle and mixed with this compressed air, then ignited with the help of igniter. The velocity of air entering into the combustion chamber must be low enough, otherwise flame may blow off. That I have already explained. Flame holder are used to stabilize the flame, which provide necessary blockage in passage to slow down the airflow. After CC, the gases are allowed to expand in the exhaust nozzle, where it leaves the engine at very high velocity, then the speed of entering air. Thus, because of rate of increase in moment of working fluid, the thrust is developed in the direction. So we will get the thrust because the jet velocity is very high as compared to the velocity of entering air. Now, advantages of ramjet engine. Ramjet engine do not have any rotating component, so obviously light in weight, simple in design, require less maintenance, less noise due to no moving part, and also SFC is better than other gas turbine power plant at high speed and high altitude, because at low altitude, or you can say low speed, SFC is very, very poor for ramjet engine. Because what is SFC? SFC is the mass of the fuel per unit thrust per unit time, so it will be high at low altitude and low speed. Now last point, you can see ramjet are most frequently used as a augmenter or afterburner or turbojet engine. What does this point imply? See, afterburner, what is afterburner? Afterburner is the you can say it is a thrust augmenting device which is used in turbojet engine at the exit of turbine and before nozzle. So you can say afterburner is placed between turbine and nozzle portion. Why it is using afterburner? Use the gases which are expanded gases from the turbine and entering into the afterburner, then fuel, extra fuel is added to the those unburned gases and burn with the help of igniter. So what will happen? We will achieve much more thrust. We can use those extra gases or unburned gases by providing extra fuel, so that we can achieve extra thrust, or we are using those unburned gases in the form of thrust. So afterburner produces at least 30% or 40% extra thrust with the consumption of 100% extra fuel. So ramjet engine actually work as a afterburner in turbojet. Same thing is written over here. So creating additional thrust we can get. But one more thing, because of the use of afterburner, the length of the turbojet engine will be increased. This is the disadvantage of afterburner. Now disadvantage of ramjet engine. Ramjet engine is not a self-starting engine. They require some booster or launching device for its initial start, hence preferred in missiles and military operation. So it is very clear, because they do not have any rotating component, obviously they need some launching device, and they are not suitable for commercial aircraft because of their high operating Mach number, and our commercial airlines are preferring only Mach number 0.8, up to Mach number 0.8 we are using. Now due to high airspeed, the combustion chamber require flame holder to stabilize the flame, which in turn lead to the total pressure losses. As I already mentioned in my first slide, that flame holder is used to stabilize the flame, but they may also lead to total pressure losses. These are the disadvantages of flame holder. They also increase the weight of the ramjet engine. Now ramjet engine have low thermal efficiency. This is the one of the biggest disadvantage. Why thermal efficiency is low? See, thermal efficiency is the ratio of output power to the heat power. Heat power is m dot f into cv, means mass flow rate of fuel into calorific value. Now heat power in combustion chamber, I have already mentioned that that combustion is taking place at the temperature of 3000 kelvin. So in 3000 kelvin means we are getting very high heat power, and thermal efficiency is the ratio of output power to the heat power. That means thermal efficiency is inversely proportional to heat power, and heat power is very high in ramjet engine, so thermal efficiency will be very low. And dissociation of combustion product at very high temperature, so it may also damage to the nozzle part. So we can say low thermal efficiency in case of ramjet engine. Now application. Application is supersonic missile, because ramjet can operate at 2 to 5 Mach number, and subsonic ramjet, those are used in target weapon in conjunction with turbojet or rocket for getting the starting thrust. Now additional point. Now how it is different from purjet engine? See, first thing, the similarity between turbojet and purjet engine, ramjet and purjet engine, is that they don't have rotating component. Why I am comparing ramjet only with purjet engine? Because this and means purjet and ramjet engine both comes under jet propulsion cycle. And those turbojet, ramjet, turbojet, turboprop and turbofan engines are the gas turbine engine. So now see the difference. Ramjet works on Brayton cycle, whereas Spurjet works on Otto cycle. Spurjet is the only engine which works on Otto cycle, that is constant volume cycle, whereas Ramjet works on the Brayton cycle, as similar to turbojet, turboprop and turbofan engine. The Brayton cycle means constant pressure heat addition, constant pressure heat rejection, that is constant pressure cycle. Second point, Ramjet is having supersonic and subsonic diffuser, but Spurjet is having only subsonic diffuser. Also, Ramjet engine does not have flapper valve grid burst, but Spurjet engine have spring loaded flapper valve grid. Now, because of the presence of flapper valve grid, Spurjet engine become less efficient, because life of the this flapper valve grid will be very less compared to other gas turbine, or we can say ramjet engine, because they don't use flapper valve grid. Also, Spurjet engine require high maintenance because of the presence of this flapper valve grid. So friends, this much for difference between Spurjet and ramjet. Now come back to the summary. Whatever I have discussed, I have mentioned that ramjet is a simple air breathing engine, and it is not a self starting due to the absence of compressor and turbine. It needs some launching device. Then I have mentioned that intake of a ramjet is considered to be very very important part, since entire compression accomplishment intake. Third point, flame holder. Flame holder is used in CC to stabilize the flame and to prevent extinguishing of the flame inside the CC for continuous combustion, so that we can achieve continuous combustion with the help of this flame holder, because at high velocity in CC flame may blow out. And last point, ramjet works on Brayton cycle and Spurjet works on Otto cycle. Thank you.